在小胖为大家采访到的是比利时超级新秀，怎么说呢？他在比利时创造了非常好的成绩，但他的年纪只有轻轻的33岁而已。我们来邀请到桑杰士的传人吉林克斯。
大家好，我是吉林克斯。
哇，吉林克斯先生有备而来。大家好，我是吉林克斯。大家好，我是小胖。
So, Mr. Gillinx, you are so young, that how come you can raise this kind of super performance in Europe? So, what's your relationship? Why you start to pigeons? The history, can you let us know?
Yes, I've started because of my father. He has pigeons and he has learned me everything since I was 5-6 years old. I have always have interest in pigeons, so I have built my experience through my father.That's the reason I feed pigeons and play pigeons.
我刚刚问吉林克斯，因为很多人都很好奇，吉林克斯为什么年纪轻轻，他养鸽子就养得那么厉害？原来是因为他从5岁的时候，他就开始跟着他的爸爸养鸽。哇，5岁这样换算下来，也养鸽足足养了28年。所以说，各位鸽友，我们要努力。人家5岁就开始养鸽了，28年的功夫就能够磨出这么好的成绩。
Mr. Gillinx, how's your father start to raise pigeons with the broadlines of Sanjes? You know, because Sanjes broadline are rare in Asia market now.
Yeah, my father is started when he was married with my mother in 77.
Yes.
And he's moved to Wommelgem. Yes. And we lived very near by Jos Sanjes. He was that time a legend.He played with the speed races very, very good. I think they said always they are the fastest pigeons from the world that time. And my father was also very interesting to play very good. So he has do a good investment to try to get the Sanjes pigeons.
Wow, so your father spent a lot of money to invest.
Yeah, in that time, yes, he wants to play also very good. And he knows always when you want to play good, you must have quality of birds. And then he tried the Sanjes pigeons, and it was a very, very good decision.
我跟吉林克斯先生说，其实桑杰士在亚洲是非常早期很珍贵的一种血统。那我就问吉林克斯，为什么他爸爸在养鸽的时候会选择桑杰士的血统呢？他跟我们说，其实那时候他爸爸跟他妈妈结婚的时候是在1977年，结完婚之后就搬到了比利时的一个小村庄。那刚刚好，当时最有名的就是乔斯桑杰士先生，就住在他们家隔壁不到50公尺。那个时候他爸爸刚开始养鸽，他爸爸的观念就是，我要比赛，我就要挑最好的种鸽开始去比赛，刚刚好又有地缘之变，所以那时候他爸爸就开始去拜访乔斯桑杰士先生。他爸爸的观念也很正确，他认为要赢鸽一定要肯投资，所以那时候他爸爸用当时的金额非常的大啦，用当时所费不赀的金额去跟桑杰士先生引进了很多桑杰士的老血。 包含像我们现在知道的晚生汤姆班雄，都是在那个时候他爸爸很早就开始跟桑杰士先生引进了。
So your father is very clever to use to introduce the Sanchez Broline so many years ago. So how come, how's the evolution of your Brolines in your family trip into nowadays?
Yes, so when my father started, he was very interesting in the speed races. Yes. So the Sanchez birds were very, very good on that discipline. But with the years, we want also try to do the national flights, the much stronger flights, 500-600 kilometers.And we feel that the Sanchez birds need to a little bit more force in their body. So my father tried to introduce a few strains much stronger. So we have crossed them.
Yes. And
because the Sanchez birds were also a little bit inbreed family, that was very good to cross with other bloodlines. And that we have tried to do. And now I think we have a good strain of birds to play until 700-750 kilometers. So I think it was a good decision to do a little bit more strength in the pigeons.
Yes. 我问吉林克斯先生，为什么他爸爸在早期引进了那么好的桑杰士的血统之后，他还能够承续他爸爸继续把桑杰士的血系发扬光大？他说关键点是因为他们也一直在调整他们家的血统。他爸爸在早期的时候呢，非常重视速度赛、短距离比赛。但后来比到后来，他们希望说能够提升自己的比赛距离到600公里、700公里左右。但在调整到中距离比赛、看国家赛的时候，他就有感觉到桑杰士的鸽子的确非常的快，但是如果要用到600到700公里比赛的时候，就有稍嫌不足，觉得鸽子不够有韧性。所以在那个时候，他爸爸做了决定，开始决定要找其他更有韧性、更有耐力的鸽系导入他们家的血统里面。那他非常认同他爸爸当时的决定。他爸爸那个时候用了很多像是史列兹、阿方斯，也就是现在有名的白头西威斯特，和贝尔拉德、范路克、弗洛尔先生，都是在那个时候引进的韧性鸽系。
So no wonder, because you keep evolution, so all your Brolines can still win lots of performance since decades. So I also heard that many super fanciers secretly use your Brolines to make their performance very well. So can you let me know, or can you let the fancier in Asia know which fancier also use your Brolines in Europe?
Yeah.I have a few very good reference the last years. First of all, also Gaston van de Wouwer, he was very, very good with my bloodlines. They won the first National Bourges with out of a hen of mine. I have also Dirk van Dijk, who won the first National. Yeah, a lot of fancier. Bert van Uckel won first National out of my pigeons. So yeah, there are Dirk van Dijk, I've told. So I think...
Unbelievable.刚刚吉林克斯先生跟我们透露了鸽界不可告人的秘密，因为我们有听说现在在欧洲鸽界很多超级名家事实上也都用吉林克斯他们家的血统，而且表现非常发挥，就是我们所说的秘密发挥这些秘密武器。那吉林克斯先生他也很大方的跟大家交流，他说据他所知啦，像是现在在中国大陆特别火红的葛斯顿范德瓦尔，就是奶酪小子的爸爸葛斯顿先生，他其实也非常喜欢用桑杰士吉林克斯家族的鸽系。还有另外一个名家，就像是所向无敌，所向无敌的爸爸就是最有名的迪克凡戴克先生，也用吉林克斯他们家的鸽系飞出了全国冠军很亮丽的成绩。那甚至包括说像考夫曼先生在2015年的时候也用了格斗士的侄孙飞入了 NPO 全国赛的12位。
So I also heard that this year the Bourges National Race PEC Loft also used your Brolines. Is that true?
Yeah, I was very happy to see that they have won the first National Bourges with a descendant of Gladiator. So the mother is a daughter of Miss Magic, my Olympic bird, and she's then the granddaughter of my Gladiator. So yes. It's nice to see that other people can win with my birds and have good results with them.
我刚刚问吉林克斯说，包含像今年 PEC， 也就是 PIPA 比利时赛歌天堂网的精英育种中心，在播至全国赛里面也用了一支吉林克斯家族的歌戏，创造了很好的成绩。吉林克斯先生跟我们说，那只鸽子叫做路易斯。路易斯他赢得了今年2016年的播至全国冠军。那一只鸽子的妈妈神奇小姐的侄女，就是格斗士的孙女，所以他也很开心，说他的鸽子能够帮 PIPA PEC 比利时精英种中心创造佳绩。
How's your opinion that why your pigeons so good that so super fancy will come to visit you?To introduce your bro line, what's the secret to your selection and your bro lines?
Well, I think it starts from the beginning. My father always said to me, you must try to keep your very best racers pigeons on your breeding loft and try to build a strain of a family around those pigeons. And we never sell my best racers, good pigeons, so we have tried to build a strain family around them. And that's, I think, also.We have a good family with performance pigeons in many generations, so I think that's the basic of everything. You must have a good family of birds.
Yes. So can you let me know what's your core bird lines nowadays in your family?
Yeah, everything is start with my first very good pigeon, Gladiator. We have tried to handle him like a diamond, and he is nowadays my basic breeder in the lofts.At the same period, we had also the good luck to have Whittacop Sylvester, yeah, to breed very, very good pigeons for me. And that, those lines are nowadays my basic from my lofts.
我问吉林克斯先生说，那他是怎么样维持让他们的血统那么的强盛，以至于这些超级名家都会愿意用他们的血统呢？他说他一直谨记他爸爸教他的一件事情，就是种鸽非常重要，所以吉林克斯它的特色就是它从来不卖超级鸽出门，不管是多少人用多少钱砸下去，它都不会把这些好的种鸽给卖出去。原因点就是它谨记它爸爸教它的东西，唯有一个好的家族性、好的遗传，才能让我们的血系更加的蓬勃发展。所以说他的鸽系因为从来都不留出门，导致说最核心的血统一直都在他们的家，所以他不断在子代、孙代、曾孙代都能够有发挥。他们家现在的血统里面最重要的主血是哪一条呢？吉林克斯先生跟我们讲，所有的鸽子都一定要从这两只鸽子先讲起，就是中国很有名的白头席维斯特，另外就是格斗士。这两只鸽子是现在他们家最重要的两条主血，那包含很多像现在即便是在发挥的鸽系，都要迁回到白头席威斯特跟格斗士这两只鸽子身上。
So, can you let us know the children or descendant, the performance from Gladiator or the Whittacop Sylvester?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, from Gladiator, his father from many good birds.But also grandfather from my Olympic birds the last years, Miss Magic, AC. So they are all in the pedigree, his Gladiator. Also from the Ace Pigeon Porsche 911 from PEC is also grandfather is Gladiator. So a lot of very good birds nowadays are from the strain of Gladiator.
Yes, 我问吉林克斯先生说啊，那可以让我们了解一下最近几年呢、啊，在格斗士跟白头席威斯特这两条主血下，有哪几只鸽子表现特别有发挥呢？他有说，像2013年的奥林匹克代表鸽有一只叫做神奇小姐，神奇小姐就是他当今格斗士的外孙女。那神奇小姐本身是在2013年的时候赢得了奥林匹克全能鸽的代表鸽冠军。神奇小姐本身是一只超级鸽之外，另外一只鸽子像是PEC 鸽舍的保时捷911，它的那一只保时捷911也是吉林克斯格斗士的那一条血统。
So how's about the Miss Magic? How's the performance breeding records of Miss Magic?
Yeah, breeding records from Miss Magic are very good, I think. Also good pigeons out of her, and also there are many good breeding.Birds out of Miss Magic. Now I think the national winner also from PSC is from Miss Magic.
Oh, yes. So, oh, you say that Louis National winner have a relationship with Miss Magic?
Yes, she's the mother, from the mother of the national winner.
Yeah. 我刚刚问起吉林克斯，那神奇小姐这一只鸽子后续的育种成绩如何呢？那吉林克斯跟我们说，神奇小姐的育种成绩也非常有发挥，包含像我们先前有提到的 PEC 波智全国冠军路易斯，就是神奇小姐的侄女做出来的，也就是那一只路易斯就是神奇小姐的外孙女。
哇 ，So very beautiful, very powerful performance of the Miss Magic it is.So, about the super cock, what's your super breeding cock nowadays in your breeding loft?
Yeah, at the moment it's still a gladiator, but I think for the future I have a very good one. We will listen, a follow up, I think. It's nowadays my Blue Lagoon.
Blue Lagoon.
He raced very, very well. He's a very strong pigeon. And now the first year on his breeding, on the breeding loft, he has given me right away the first national ace bird, Little Star. So I think he will follow up my gladiator in the breeding loft.
我刚刚问起吉林克斯，神奇小姐是一只很漂亮的育种型的母鸽之外，有没有什么样的超级现役的种公呢？他说现役的种公当然除了格斗士之外呢，他还有一只鸽子，鸽友们赶快把他笔记抄下来，叫做灰拉贡。Blue Lagoon， 灰拉贡是他现在最看重的一只种鸽。这只种鸽是2010年生的，还有很大的育种空间。他对灰拉贡特别有印象是，是灰拉贡进了种鸽鸽舍的第一年，就给他生出了一只全国鸽王冠军。这只全国鸽王冠军就叫做小明星，他是灰拉贡的侄子。小明星在灰拉贡第一年做出的时候，就为他赢得了2015年的 KBDB 全国大中距离一岁鸽王的冠军。
So how's the Little Star? The Little Star is nowadays your super racing superstar in your breeding loft. Can you let us know the broad lines behind the Little Star?
Yes. Yeah, the father from Little Star is on Blue Lagoon.
Yes.
He is son of one of my best breeding in with Ben Wouters.
Yes.
She is a direct from Marcel Wouters from West Mal. The bloodline behind that is the Leo, the lion from him. Mm. And the mother of Little Star is from also my basic breeders, Blue Iron Eisern with Willeke.
Yes.
The strain of Willeke. Mm. So it's a very good bloodline.
Yes.吉林克斯先生，我问起他说：“哇，那小明星这只鸽子那么厉害的一岁鸽鸽王冠军，背后的血统可以跟我们解释一下吗？”吉林克斯跟我们说，小明星的爸爸就是刚刚所讲到的灰拉贡。灰拉贡其实妈妈那头就是马歇尔沃特斯狮王号的全姐妹，有一只叫做白羽沃特斯。那白羽沃特斯也扮演了在吉林克斯他们家族里面很重要的角色。小明的妈妈是铁血女郎。铁血女郎就是吉林克斯他们家另外一只超级鸽陆克的全姐妹。铁血女郎呢也是很关键的一条血统，因为铁血女郎灰铁汉这一路的血统的引进，让吉林克斯能够从桑杰士的速度鸽开始往上提升到中距离比较有韧性鸽的比赛。
So Mr. Gillings, we are so happy that you visit Asia Oven.And for us, we are all a new generation, the teenagers in the pigeon racing business. So can you give us some advice for the beginner like us to racing pigeon business? What your advice you will give to them?
First of all, pigeon sport is a passion. You must be passionate about pigeons, and then you must try to build a good family of birds, based on very good birds, quality birds. And then you must try.To get them to good results, but the basic is, I think, very good quality birds and good performance in the pedigree, are there good descendants?
最后呢，我们问吉林克斯先生，像小胖我啊，也是鸽界里面非常年轻的新鲜人。吉林克斯能够用33岁的年纪就在欧洲赛鸽歌坛里面闯出一片天，他能不能给我们这些年轻人一些新的想法，或是有什么建议？吉林克斯跟我们说，两件事情最重要。第一个，你一定要有热情，因为你有你的热情，你才可以坚持你的选择，不会轻易的放弃你的选择。第二件事情，你在种鸽引种上一定要非常的小心， 就像是他刚刚一直强调的，我们要为了找到好的种歌，就要坚持维系它。尤其是你在配对上的时候，他非常重视歌王能够在多关赛比赛里面都能够创下佳绩的实战种歌，一定会是第一个首选。
Yeah.